Metamorphosis continuing, getting into the our section. Akibulan, our story. Kmit. The thing that we know that is deep in our DNA, in our ancestral memories, but has been overpowered by recent experiences, traumas and violence. But part of the salvation is in recovery. And we have to recover our own culture, our own story, the way that we really used to grow our children. Because what we're experiencing now was never part of our previous experience before we got contact with the Europeans. We never knew anything about child molestation. We never knew about pedophiles. We never knew about child violence and murdering. That is something that is alien to I and I know. So we need to reflect and to gather the strength based upon the knowledge of where we're coming from, all the things construct, and to observe the deviations taking place right now. So before we were captured and uprooted, males and females are always running around Africa, because we know that in the Genesis Bible story, for those who embrace it, that on the sixth day, when God said, "Let us make Africans, males and females created he them," and he sent Africans out to multiply and replenish. The Bible called them man, but is African man. Them drop off the part there. So we're there about a long time, and we have had relations, and we have had civilizations, and we have had dynasties. So we know about family. There is no if and but about our awareness of family. But where we reach today, we have lost our way. So nothing wrong with a little refresher. as to what really is a family. Now, we have to maintain the concept of culture in mind when we speak about family. Culture. How do the individuals relate at the gender level? And then how they relate as they extend themselves outwardly. Now, I want to just make a point and then tell you about my guest in the studio of the female nature. So it's going to be combustious. Any word goes so? Anyway, it sounds good. Now, the idea of family and leadership. We're going to raise the issue of leadership first. Because once we're going to talk about a family, we're going to talk about some aspect of leadership. Because there must be some form of direction that the family is undertaking. They don't just stand up in space, not just static. It going somewhere, something dynamic. So leadership now becomes the first issue that we're going to talk about. And before we talk about the leadership now, there are two people that we know begin a family. And because I'm a traditionalist, when I start with nothing else except with male and female. You know anything else? By the way, my guest is Paulette Stepper from Stepping Out Loud. Greetings, Paulette.
Greetings, Dr. Black.
Them can hear her?
Greetings, Dr. Black.
All right.
Hearing me? Yeah.
Yeah, so you know, say, not I alone now.
Stepping out in the
Right.
metamorphosis.
What a thing now.
Wow.
Pure stepping, right? All
No.
right, so where are they now? We're looking at what is it we used to recognize as family before we get caught up by the slave ship and put into the bottom of the ship and brutalized and terrorized and turned into chattel and then released and emancipated and themselves have gone now and are free. So in this free thing now, we say we're going to make family. What is the model? What do we look at to emulate as we talk about family? No, the leadership thing now. Call it.
Family, me think family. Family definitely come from mother and father.
Mother and father.
Yeah, but we tend to forget the parent, the grandparents them too, which is basically the one who teach the mother and the father them.
And they were mother and father too.
Yeah, man, grandmother and my grandfather.
All right.
Yeah, man.
So the concept of mother and father, we all hold that as foundation.
But it can't be no other way.
Well, there's an attempt, and we shall explore that later on. A serious attempt to change that has serious implications for even our generations to come. Now, in terms of leadership now, before we made any contact with the Europeans, we had to had a regime to determine how the family would grow, who would provide leadership in the family. Now, two kind of frameworks we know out of African studies. One that is driven by the mother, and one that is driven by the father. One we're gonna call patriarchy. And the other we're going to call matriarchy. Now, there is also societies that are what we're going to call patrilineal, and there are societies that we're going to call matrilineal. So, in other words, now before we even get caught up into this Western world and for them thing with them put upon we did other things.
Long time.
All right. The thing now don't tell us say no. You have two type of lineage you can have. You can have a lineage where it runs from the mother and the descent and the herd and all the property business is defined by the mother. You have another system where all those things are defined by the father line. Matrilineal societies, patrilineal societies. All right. The matrilineal society now is what I think we need to pay a little bit attention to, because the patrilineal is what has been forced upon us.
Patrilineal.
Yes. So what do think?
You started.
All right. So now, the patrilineal, well, the language that we have more use is patriarchy. We're more under a patriarchal system as black people in this Western world now. But as I'm saying, we know about the matriarch. And the matriarch is an important part of African culture because it is a situation where the woman has precedence to the level where that she can become the governance. Remember now, you know, we have African rulers who were women. So we don't have no problem with women as leaders, you know, queens and pharaohs, you know.
Probably back then, but no, if you notice, know, well, it probably just a come up back now, woman, but it's a man world out there now, man, a ruler world.
You think so? What is man rule the world? The world wants some adjustment because the world not run right.
It's too much manpower, so the femininity gone. So I think that's
You think it
why
can
then
imbalance?
change, yeah, the system kind of changed now. So because so much man up there, the motherly touch has gone. You
So
know that
how?
motherly touch, so
No,
that's
tell me
why
about it. Tell me about it. Because I'm a man. Tell me about that motherly touch.
that mother, because woman and man have to be together in order for anything to, as in human being life to create, whichever way you put it.
So who should lead in a relation?
I think it should be, why it have to be some of the leaders, why them can't be compatible and
But decisions have to be made. We understand compatibility, that's why they're together. Them compatible.
Yeah.
But them have to do things. Them have
So
to
all should,
create, them have to build, them have to make decisions. Them have to do things.
yes, them
So
have,
decisions have to be made. So may I say no? Is there any?
can they not talk about it and come to
Of
understanding?
course, but you have to make
Yes.
a decision.
Yeah, so if you
So,
come to understanding now, the
right.
decision will be made.
Okay, then suppose there's a difference in opinion.
Well, usually a man win.
What? No, win and lose, no. No, man. We're not talking about winning and losing, no. We're talking about coming to
Coming to a
and
amicable,
who are overstanding.
yeah, so, oh, well,
Well, I mean, that's what we know it before
yes.
we're brought into this competition and debate, no.
Yeah. And it's usually been manpower. Usually, sometimes woman too, because them say the woman tend
So
to.
you as a female now, you wanna feel say you have enough power for can
No. No, you
eh?
can't ask me that
Yeah, but me
question.
ask you, man.
Because me probably be biased, as in the sense where me feel a woman to speak up for what
Yeah.
them really believe into
Right.
and stop being in the shadow. Some of them.
Okay.
And probably on that aspect of life, then probably me be a white man who understand more. I think woman step back too much.
Okay, so now, is this now the woman in Jamaica or this woman in general you're talking about? Waiting,
Wow.
waiting. Who are you speaking of now?
General, like African woman,
Yeah.
wow, is a deep question
Well,
that Dr.
the program is as it is. All right, so
Black.
we'll make it work into that next. Now, the notion of family and man and woman relations. I think on the plantation here today, now we don't really have a proper model. The model
No.
that we have been looking at is what Europe set up in front of it.
And it confuses us.
It definitely goes against the nature of ourselves because, for example, now relationships, monogamy, and polygamy, these are two different ways of organizing a family. But it seems to be a big problem in the Western world, when the African man tried to practice polygamy. So that I do something about. I mean, I understand how he does something. So,
Because that's an African system.
all right. So, but it's having a problem in the West.
And then African system is a system where a white man rule the Western world.
Yeah.
So basically what is being what is what was or is in Africa is basically not even known out here.
But it is in our behavior, you know.
It is in our behavior, that's why we
Yes.
behave that way, because it is us, really.
So you don't think maybe then we should begin to face our behavior and adjust that more than try to imitate continuously what
It's
this
not
man.
imitating, it's controlling. We are being controlled that way.
We're being controlled.
Yes.
Tell me more about that.
Control in the sense that if you do it, it has a law against it, so you can't be yourself, so you're controlled.
Okay, so what? So is really. So what is there a force that controls? Is it some kind of body that directing how we must behave amongst ourselves as African people? Something directing us why we behave how we behave?
Directing not just now,
yeah.
Basically, hundreds of years now.
Long time now.
Yeah, man. Part of the system that is.
So, like something written in a book? Anything written in a book?
It's probably written in a book, but probably it's been instilled in us for us to behave that way.
So, the man now, the African man on the plantation, he has been released through emancipation and he has been told that he is free and that he must go out and farm a family.
Mm hmm.
So him go out and him find a female and him decide to have some offspring. You know the mind now. Who really responsible for that child? Is really him or her or is a both? Is a two?
Both of them, because the two of them created the child.
Both of them?
Yeah. Although the woman carries a child, but it could not have been there without a man place it there.
I know the man couldn't put it there unless he put it there, unless she had kind of agreed.
Consent, yes.
So, look, the responsibility may shift more a little bit from the man, or what do you think?
No, it's a consent, it's a understanding.
Right.
Sex is love and, you know, what
brings. So you're saying sex is love?
Me supposed
you know
to be.
I don't have to realize that.
No, but no, and that may I say what I said. It's supposed to be. We know that. But
no, me don't know. No, you can't say we know that.
No,
no,
man, and Dr. Black.
No, man, you can't say I don't know. It's all I know.
All right, love, all right, sex, yeah. All right, yeah.
So you said,
yeah, because, yeah.
Because those are some of the issues that, you know, when we're forming these relations, why when the children born, everybody run, you know.
Because it got formed too much of a hurry.
And sometimes we're not clear as to what is it that
and
brings that brings us together.
Mm-hmm.
So, just because you mentioned the point, is sex love though? What do you think?
Sex is not love.
So, what is love then?
Love is just natural feeling.
So, sex
love.
Is a natural feeling, so?
Boy, yeah. Sex is a natural feeling and love a natural feeling. Mm. But you can't just get intimate with anybody
oh,
like
no,
that.
No,
as you feel it.
No, but you mentioned a different word, no, intimate. Why are you going different? No, think I love you that about all the way. You can't see the camera on the corner.
Economic liberation is a duty I owe to posterity. Great Zimbabwe stands, ancient rocks are the firm. Come now, Jacob go down. Great Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe walls. When they saw Zimbabwe walls, they said it was the foundation. They said it was a Syrian. They said it was a Chinese. When they saw Zimbabwe wall, they said it came from the Iberian. We know it is 100% African. Yaga ya, naga naga na ya. Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe walls, great Zimbabwe. So Walter Raleigh, so who was Amerigo Vespucci? Some kind of Johnny come lately, talking about them make some kind of discovery. Iman is the living anthropology. Iman is the living archaeology. Yaga yaga yo, Zimbabwe wall, great Zimbabwe wall, Zimbabwe wall, great Zimbabwe.
Yeah, metamorphosis continuing. Looking into the old nature of how black family used to operate before we were captured and turned into chattel and then turned loose and just wild. And man just turned stud and woman just start breed like fish. And then when they spawn them and the baby fish them come out, they must high about the place. No direction, no ownership. On the African continent, no, these type of societies, these things would not occur. Because the offspring didn't belong to just the mother and the father. That child was brought into a community. That child was brought into a relationship with families that already existed. That's a big difference from just drop a seed and run, you know. And then you say, you have a youth at Westmoreland.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's about my 5 youth. And you say, yeah, we see, yeah, man, who are 5 youth, me have, you know. And you say, then with them, the boy, you want to see one over so. And you say, when I just say them, boy, you want to see.
Probably only know 3.
That is what must stop. We have to arrest that and begin to save the children. You know, if you really want to save the children, we have to return to our cultural ways, our normal, natural ways, our divine, the divine order that created societies like Zimbabwe and ancient Egypt and Mali and Songhai and Atlantis. We have to respect the nature of family. You know, I come to Jamaica, yeah, and you say family no good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you hear that too?
Yeah, it's a regular thing.
Wait,
enough of Portland.
Well, yeah, but wait, people really mean by that? You think, I mean,
family's not united. They are not united.
That's a regular thing. Cassidy, ever hear that yet? Family no good.
Yeah.
So how can we embrace that and talk about the value of a child now? So how the child can be valuable when the family
no good,
when the concept of family no good? We find that them things are distracting and disturbing, you know?
Yeah, when you start instill that in the child brain from the child little bit, so automatically the child become no good because the family,
they're part of the family.
Yeah,
you know. So we are using some destructive language amongst ourselves. That the man who divide, we do have a combat amongst you, you know.
No,
him they're on Mars now. You understand? He have a new satellite where I see him further in the cosmos.
And I laugh.
He have a underground thing. I try reinvent how the universe begin. And this is him there love with female eagles, you know. And we there now a strive and a war amongst ourselves because we can't construct a family.
We can't leave that this yet.
So the way forward is to look where we're coming from. I guess that's why you have rear view mirror in cars, you know. You know that.
The more you're tuning in the car.
You know, so every now and then you have to take a trip to the rear view.
Yeah.
Yeah, for see where I'm going.
As much
as you're going forward, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That is why it is there. And that's why we have our story, what we call history. It's really our story. What happened in Kemet, what happened in Al-Kibulan. That is our story. And if we can resurrect our story, then we can reject his story.
Yeah.
Easy. And deal with the culture that we know. So male and female now. This thing called jealousy. Boy, me, I'll tell you. What a puro.
What a thing.
This thing called jealousy now. As a female, are you jealous?
No, I don't have no jealousy.
Stop it, man.
Me.
Stop it.
I don't have no jealousy. I think jealousy.
No, you can't come to my office and tell lies. So.
I don't tell a lie. Jealousy is insecurity. That's my.
Right, may I hear you?
I feel jealousy. Jealousy is insecurity.
All right, so hold on now. So,
why are you jealous?
Hold on now. So if a person is insecure, right? Is that a bad condition to be in?
You need to control that emotion. It's an emotion.
It's an emotion.
Yes.
Mm.
And you need to control that and get deeper into yourself and loving yourself more than that. You can probably overcome that insecurities will cause jealousy.
All right. That sounds like step up. Give me some psychological therapy now. Because at a certain level now, you know, I think the Western conditioning,
mm-hmm,
that has programmed the jealous God into us,
mm-hmm,
make us jealous by nature almost.
Yes. Yeah. Always are jealous of one another.
And I'm saying, no. So, what is it? Is it just about insecurity then? Is it just about insecurity?
Why?
What do you think? If you're jealous about everything, what is the insecurity now? Why is somebody going to feel jealous? I think we need to examine, you know, what is the root cause of jealousy.
Yeah,
you say insecurity. You're suggesting that if you're secure, you won't be jealous,
or they can become less jealous if they have jealousy in them. Yeah, probably me not have it, so me can't really talk.
Is that the same thing as wanting what the next person have? Is that jealousy?
Wow. It can be that, and then it can want to, and then you can see somebody with something you don't want it, but you just don't want to see them with it too.
All right. No, me take that another step. No, me call that envy.
Yes. Yeah. So jealousy turn into envy.
Yeah, me think that is the next step.
Yes. Yeah, could be.
Yeah,
could
Mr. Theorize says another stage. And it can move from that to something even more deadly.
So because it is a...
It's a progression.
Yes. Once you get into it,
yes.
It's just like you're getting deeper into it.
And deeper.
So it turns from jealousy to envy.
To rot.
It's a process, it's a program.
No, may I say to you now? Them give we the tip of the program and make we hook it up.
And we carry it where we won't carry it.
But no, it lead you where it will go.
If you allow it to embrace it.
Yeah, if you hug it up.
Yeah.
It's going to take you where you want it to
be. Yeah, if you hug it up. Yeah, true. Yes.
So I'm going to say to you now, the people who hug up the idea of jealousy, that it is okay. Can you have some people say nothing wrong with being jealous?
No, them feel all right about it.
Because their God is also jealous.
Them inner self.
Yeah, no, the inner God, not the Bible, the Christian Bible.
Oh,
God.
Yeah, because your God is a jealous God.
He's a jealous God.
Oh, because that is, oh, yeah. Oh.
Metamorphosis. Metamorphosis continuing now. I was looking into the psychology now of the African woman before she got caught up into this Western Christianized framework that she now defending jealousy because her God is a jealous God. Hey, that dread thing, you know. Step up. Step up that dread thing, you know.
That thing's still in our way, you know.
Hey, that dread thing, you know. Yeah, man. That's
it's funny how them sometimes them turn the Bible in or some. Different.
Turn it. Or is what it is.
Yeah, we are.
But seriously, though, watch me now. The whole idea of an African woman, a black woman, in a relationship with a next woman.
What?
Listen to this.
Oh.
A woman
mm-hmm.
in relationship with a next woman
mm-hmm.
who's in relationship with a next woman. who are all in relationship with a man.
No, that one confuse me.
No, man, listen to this.
Three women in a relationship, yeah, by themselves?
No, with a
with,
man.
With one man?
Of course.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah, mm-hmm. We're not getting into
it. It's like the three, like a man having three wives.
All right, you want to put it away. You want to put it away there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm saying no. Those women.
But that happened regularly in Jamaica, you know, whether you want to face it or not.
No, we'll soon face that too.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're not facing it.
Yeah.
That's a part of the problem. Mm-hmm. We're unwilling to face it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm saying we must take that out of the closet now.
Yeah.
Because if the B man them can come out and the gay man them and mm-hmm. everybody can come out,
we must come out.
Team
yes,
must come out.
Too. Yes, yes.
Right, so I emphasize that now. But I said, you know, about the women who have them relationship mm-hmm. with each other and the man. Right? They don't have any time to be jealous
mm-hmm.
of each other.
Yeah, because them progress.
Them progressive.
Mm-hmm.
And them concerned about the relationship
mm-hmm.
that them have with each other and the man.
Can I say this?
You can say what you want to say, man.
This is happening right now in Jamaica.
No, it's not happening.
It is happening.
All right.
Hear how me put it
right,
now.
The
upscale man, uptown with him wife.
Yeah.
And have a baby mother, him wife living in a cherry garden. But him have a baby mother in a Avondale and
yeah.
him maintain both homes.
Yeah.
And then him put them in a him give them successful business. And them,
okay.
Them
they
and
pass,
basically
progressing.
The wife knows yeah. about the sweetheart and obviously the sweetheart knows about the wife and then them two just want to keep it so but probably a lot of younger girl coming at the play. Round
so,
the road.
So this is what
this happens in Jamaica right
okay.
now.
So is it
and this is part of African. Me see it as part of we African living, part of but because we're free to live it freely
yeah.
as we were before originally and it is in our system. So we're coming now, so we is
so
now,
why
other
think,
people.
Why
you
know? Think those two women now are not jealous?
They're money and they are well taken care of, and then the economics of
economics
it basically
is it proper.
Yeah, the economics of it is that everybody are progressing at the end of the day, you know? And the man who is basically the who put this thing together,
yeah,
he make all of the women them know each other because probably if it wasn't him,
yeah, that was
Jane would meet Mary, right. Yeah.
So, so may I advocate say we must make this be something more. Formalized in Jamaica now and break away the hide and seek.
But the
I say no, yeah, it's pure hide and seek.
Yeah, which is hide and seek, but then on that side of the world, but on the other side, it is more emphasis is putting on.
On what? Put on what?
Right now, the emphasis, they're not open up, not nothing. It's like, you can't carry a baby father, got a coat for you, whatever, but right now, the emphasis.
But all them talk about baby father and all them things have done, you know.
What them for call them?
Look here, man.
Your partner, your...
Look
well,
here. In other words, you know, all the language want to change up.
Yeah.
That the thing become more respectable, formalized, you know? Yes, and look here. You see, make the point of a...
We're reading a history where man of 10 wives.
Yeah.
And all of the wives, them are do well.
Is that not poor
and
man?
And this month, them know it's June.
Yeah.
Of September, this girl and June had them spend like for the 3 months them
yeah,
spend it there.
At a certain place.
At certain homes.
So no.
And then when him at that home is building time, you get where I come
man.
From.
So,
and when him
so,
come back next year, she's supposed to grow.
So maybe it's like a money why the women in the West have such a difficult time. It must go okay. Let me put it this way: you have enough man now who coming off of the plantation history who used to read the Bible too. And then Mr. Rebo with Solomon.
Mm-hmm.
And so enough man get the idea now, say, man, if you have enough wife.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's in the Bible. Right?
Mm-hmm.
No. What did man not realizing in the story is that all those men who the Bible story talk about had many wives, had much, much, much property.
Yeah, own towns.
I'm going to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
So now, there must be a correlation between plenty wives and plenty money.
Because they have to bail.
Okay. So, I think it's not just about sex then. Because the issue now in the Western world now is sex.
Yeah.
And the woman will fight over the something.
You know, the black world.
You know, this plantation world now that we're into.
Mm-hmm.
The struggle now seems to be over the sex between the female. What do you think about that? Them women that would not describe, who
yes,
have them, who are securing them thing and thing, they not seem to be behaving the way we so are going wrong. Way. So who are going, yes or no? Why the fight over the sex here?
Me always wonder that, do I know?
But you know, you stop wonder, man. Stop wondering, give me a input, man.
Why them fight over it?
Yeah, why the fight now?
Probably too good and they don't want nobody to share it. What and just mean? Want it to jealousy thing again.
Yeah, but in other words, that can't be a jealousy now. That's all like
fight.
That's all like ownership. That's all like some ownership.
They don't envy.
Now.
I want it for yourself, so you go fight for it.
So,
and the mentality
but
where...
So, is that something you can own?
But the man put him mark on the property, the woman
the
too, you
man
know.
Man put him mark?
Yeah, man, the man and, go on like him own the woman
and,
too,
and
you
the
know.
And woman tell the man, say, you're a one, listen up.
Yeah,
and,
the two way to go,
you know. You can't see Metamorphosis, deconstructing myths and allegories, nursery rhymes and fairy tales. and all the various devices that they throw in our brains to confuse us. Well, amongst that confusion is the whole idea of the first family. You know, they always talk about, say, there's a first. Every time we like to talk about the first this and the first that. And there must be a first. Was there a first family?
First,
yeah,
is
was there a first family?
It's not just one. Them always put it to one thing. Mm. Like, it's a one and one.
Yeah, like.
And I think that's why we're still saying everybody want to be this one person.
All right, I'm going to try to imitate this first person.
Yes, and the only them person, that one person, that is a problem with us, you know, that one, well, them alone can do this. And
within the concept of family now, I will look into the history books that they give us. If we look upon the book that embraces, what African people embrace on the plantation, their holy book. As within the holy book now, there are stories about the creation of mankind and family and... So it's something about that book that maybe if we look at that first family, we see whether we should continue to follow how that family behave, or whether we should just reject that family.
So God said that is the family
we
must look at.
Yeah, that's the first family, right.
Okay. All
it's
right,
the first family. We don't have nothing else to look at.
Okay.
As far as where them give it. Right?
Sure.
This family there before even Flintstones, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
But one. Why one?
Original.
Okay.
Original.
Okay. Okay.
Original. I'll see what look.
Okay.
Out of King James Version.
Mm.
All right. So we're going to come again.
This is Styles FM.
Take us to work. Take us on the go. Take us wherever you go. Styles FM.
Take Styles FM with you on the go. The number for USA, 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. And for the United Kingdom, 033-0010-3322. That's
033-0010-3322. Styles FM.
Hey, are you ready? You ready? All right. All right, let's go. Do you know what time it is? Do you know what time it is? Yes, it's on a Saturday. Every Saturday morning, live on Styles 96.1, the People Station. Here's an invitation to join yours truly, Colin Anthony, the man with all the money, honey. The program is called Smooth Sailing. Every Saturday morning from 9 o'clock until 1 on the p.m. It's going to be on Styles FM 96.1. Have you got a plan? You've got a plan? We've got a plan. Do remember to join us. Smooth sailing.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Corbin, St. Mary's, Styles FM, the People's Station is now on your radio. 96.1 and 96.7 on your FM band.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. Styles FM, your northeastern radio station based in Portland, Jamaica. Tune in now.
Thank you.
going on? Metamorphosis, Afrocentric Views and News. Well, what's really going on? Too many things to talk about at once, globally. So I'm not going to focus on to what's happening locally. And the plantation is in a disruptive mood as the workers who were former slaves, they now have a new title, worker. More distinction to it, not true.
Worker.
You're a worker.
You're working.
And you don't go to the plantation anymore. You know, go to the factory.
Your office.
Your office.
Yeah,
okay. Mm-hmm. Well, we're having a problem in our society here because the same 96% make up the bulk of those who are what you call workers, civil workers,
mm-hmm.
firemen, policemen,
teachers,
nurses, doctors, the foundation that makes the plantation functional.
Mm-hmm.
99% of those people come from the 96% of black people here. They are educated, they are trying to improve their lives, they're trying to be legal, they're trying to be moral.
Mm-hmm.
But something is deeper than that. Oh, you can not get paid. Increase in 5 years.
And then,
you must take care of your family.
Yeah.
Or you do it.
Yeah.
Or it work. As a female now, and you have children, and you don't get a raise for 5 years.
And cost of living keep going up.
And cost of dying is going up too. Yeah, that's everything going up.
Everything so, will go up.
Oh, we'll counteract that. Because if the children are at risk, and the people who are their parents are genuine workers and can't really generate enough money legally to take care of them kids, that the kids now have to be sent out on them own go hustle.
And that's why the government have PAD program.
What kind of program?
PAD.
No, we want a total program, we want a PAD program. We want some more comprehensive programs.
True.
What do you call it?
No, me. It's named the PAT program.
The PAT program.
Help people for go to school if them not, the parents can't afford it.
So you don't think we can find any other ways to bring forward a better level of earning?
When we look a bit in a go to school, me and my friend them talked about this recently.
Yeah.
We get milk powder. We get eye dentists. We get with teeth look bald. We get everything.
Why?
Free.
But not really free in life. Who was
but
paying
we used
for
to
that?
Get it at park school,
yeah,
man.
But somebody was paying for that, though.
Probably it was offered to us through the system of the governance.
You see that now? I think we love too much free in this island. You know, we get accustomed to free, what we think is free. But they say in the Jamaican society, nothing is free. And they say when they tell us that we are independent,
mm-hmm.
those who govern us didn't tell us that we were financially responsible for ourselves. You know?
No, that's the problem.
Them tell us that we're free. And something miss right there, so. Because in that freeness, we're broke.
The freedom.
We're
free. But then we have to create forget income now.
Oh, we're going to do? What are we going to do now to get income?
But we have to be creative.
Yeah, I hear that word over and over. I could get practical. Give me a suggestion. Practical.
Mm-hmm.
Can I give it to you now? You see, because in reality, you know, leadership is about example.
Yeah.
And you see, if you freeze the salaries of the workers, those who govern must also have their money frozen too. If not frozen, it should be cut. Why the nurses and the teachers can't run together and demand that MPs cut them salary otherwise?
Them for strike, man.
So why?
Yeah, man, the teacher, them forget more pay. The nurse, them forget more pay. They have to find some other way for source up. Although, they will say the IMF,
I am telling you where the money coming from.
But we have to find, I don't know.
So
people,
don't
them think that the private sector, the people, them for find a way. For a country that's realistically in a Jamaica, our country.
Right. So it's the
people.
In
our thing, so we can't.
So the people who are governing, everybody can't take less. May I ask you? We can't pay them less. Yeah, we can't pay them less.
We don't know what they're getting. We never want to vote for them.
No, but they have a thing. But you can't, but no, but you can't, they are not.
But they not work.
What kind of work they do?
No, but look here now.
Me look here.
Hear what I say.
Me listen.
Every person get a pay.
You defend the politician.
No, me not defend nobody money.
So,
me defend work getting paid for work being done.
But nurses and doctors they're not getting paid for work being done.
And none of them alone are getting paid for work being done.
So why don't cut the MP work too? Why don't cut pay money too?
How much am I getting?
No, but what kind of thing is this? I don't know how you ask how much am I getting.
But no, so
people
them are getting. But we don't know how much money them are getting.
You know how much teacher I get?
Yeah, man, because my son a teacher, them not get nothing.
So you think the MP I get nothing?
My engineer, you know, my teacher, them not get nothing.
So MP not get nothing? I bet the MP I get far more than your son who has been trained as an engineer. You don't want challenge that. Hey, hold on, man. You're a politician. Hold
on. No, he's not. No politician. No, wind me up on this. Sure. Metamorphosis.
For the politician, you're the same.
I want black.
Warning.
Yes, this is Janine. Warn them here, my daughter. Warn them. Rastafari, I know.
Watch the language that you use. Ensure a comprehension with the words them that you choose. Try a statement or attention, you will lose. Unless you are intentionally trying to confuse. Cause I refuse to sit back and watch you hold the people down. In your top positions while the rest of them are drawn. Cause in the sentence of creation, all you are is just a noun. The verbs, action, words that put the power to the stone. And that's way beyond profound. When the wealth is for the few, they feel that there is no one they should have to answer to. So the things that they will say are not the things that they will do. Cause even after all the talk, the people still don't have a clue. But at least this much is true, information is the key. Yes, knowledge is the only way the people will be free. So it isn't just a choice, it's a responsibility. To keep aware, so you can judge if what they say is what you see. Cause this one is a warning.
Looking into the local issues and we're trying to find money because the IMF is directing the financial ways of this country. The governance has surrendered based upon decades of slackness and borrowing and irresponsible financial measures that it's I and I now paying it to taxation. We're bleeding. Now them gone on the road and them raising the motor vehicle tickets and them raising the ganja ticket and them is a one set of raising enough. They don't there walk up and down to, you know, cause they're raising up. You know what happens, they don't there. Enough dead out of the street, man, tell you. But seriously now, look here, man. What is wrong with cutting the governor general money? What kind of service this man giving this country that we can't do without? And that we have to spend millions of pay him, made them, him servant, him driver them, him yard boy them. But for pay
remember
for that.
Remember, said this man make money away from being.
No, I'm not asking
them. Said.
You mean as a Seventh-day Adventist? I'm not sorry, Patrick.
You have a profession, you know.
What these is his profession?
These MPs are professionals.
Tell me them. Professional people don't turn MPs.
So the doctor for Portland,
which one?
The MP for Portland is a professional doctor.
So you see him do anything?
He's a doctor.
But we want politicians, we don't want doctors to try to pretend to be politicians. Doctors must go and be doctors.
So why the doctor can't be a politician? So politician, what you say now? If a politician is a politician, he can't have another job.
That's the point. Because governance is a full-time work. And governance is a full-time work.
So because of that, none too caught up in him other work.
And can't do the work.
He's
a country for life.
Okay.
Yeah, man, okay. That's why I defend him so.
Now I'm just getting clarification.
Yeah, serious thing. What purpose that man serving? That is more important than the nurse. What function Governor General serve him more than telling man say imparting them from life sentence? That's how powerful?
The Governor General.
Yeah,
yes,
they can
pardon. They don't read it. They don't know what him of a take on.
They don't oath.
Yes.
Yeah, oath. You know oath is.
Sure.
You know that oath is.
OATH.
And I'm saying to you now, if we are struggling to pay the workers who make the plantation function, nurses, teachers, firemen, how can we be expanding this thing for a place called King's House? We're not the king on here. Any king live here?
Yeah, we are.
Who's the king?
You're not king.
No, I live up, but I live on my gates.
Oh.
I live on my gates. I don't live in a special place where the tax people tax money and maintain me. Why we can't cut that? Why are we afraid to cut those things?
Because it's a world thing. It's not really
it
serves
no
Jamaica.
Function.
It's not just Jamaica alone.
No, Jamaica alone have a governor general and independent.
This happens all over the world now.
Where?
White House, upon the White House.
What about
and
the White House?
And the same kind of money them pay for the servants
people,
and all
America,
of these people.
But the people in America getting those who are...
Every country have these things, you know. It's not like Jamaica alone,
yeah,
exclusively.
Every country, yeah, Jamaica
exclusive.
Only country under the IMF and begging and borrowing. We are the only country under the thumb of the IMF. The whole new country. Greece underneath it. And Greece come out. Greece lick out and
but come out.
But
we come out.
And we go back underneath it.
So we have to come out again.
So then I try to show you know,
yeah,
there's something wrong with the type of government. We pay people 63 MP for run Jamaica. 63 people for
so
run.
So much you think them need for run here?
About six people. You
for
know,
run Jamaica?
So no one governor run California. California one big place, you know.
Yeah,
Texas crazy. Big, you know.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah. Run another, Jan.
So, you know me love my belly cause I just summer grow. And my favorite thing in bring for me is avocado. Avocado, me love the avocado. Avocado, me love the avocado. Avocado, me love the avocado. Avocado, me love the... And when the pear not in the season, still him know when my wall.
Now, there's one more thing I want to speak to within the local settings now. Besides the MPs getting, you know, there's an MP who had volunteered to cut him salary not too long ago. Yes, and the rest of them wouldn't follow. No, they can, but them greedy. You see, it's greed, you know. It's greed. And because I'm going there poor, maybe we need...
You shouldn't go in as governance for it.
But if you do that, no, them say your classes. That means they exclude poor people from governance. You see now? And when you make it, yeah, and when you make it open up for the poor people who do have them, some of them go in as cook. And all right.
Them done.
Before them get in there. And then when them get in there, that's what everybody doing in there. I take out for themselves. So now,
put them in there now.
So the nurses and the teachers and we out here now. And those
people
don't
remember said them at the government, you know. Them don't remember them thing they know.
Chum man. You see what I want? And we are out here begging now for a raise. And them might give themselves a raise before the thing happened.
What do you think the teacher them should I do?
Alright. You really want me to tell you?
Yeah, more you right. Tell me.
Let me tell you something constructive first. Okay, before me tell you something destructive. No, constructively now. In order to shake off the legacies of slavery and borrowing. Them say we must develop our own income. We must begin to create foreign exchange. Mm-hmm. I may say no. Foreign exchange meaning we must become an industrial nation. And what we are linked at with industry is farming. So the way out is through industrial farming.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we have the crop.
Yeah.
We have the crop, you know.
Which crop?
It's only one crop.
The hemp?
Hey, run ooh la for me. We have the crop here. We're eating the crop is now that can break out and set us a little bit more free.
Sensimilia, not medi marijuana.
It sounds like, you know, don't think about the farming.
Yeah.
What you know about the ganja farming? I think you have a little
ganja farming right now, yeah. Trying to be modified. Am I trying to modify medi marijuana to the people there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if them want to work with it, them work with it. But right now, me want going on some real deep research in our sensimilia. What is there? Well, it's a medicinal purpose.
Medicinal.
Yeah, thing. Yeah. My name Montel, the youth there. Read on the Facebook. He had multiple sclerosis.
Okay, multiple sclerosis.
Yes, yeah. For years.
Yeah.
And the doctor couldn't cure him.
Mm-hmm.
And he referred medi marijuana to him.
Mm-hmm.
And for the past 6 years, it's really making him. Yeah.
You know, that recently there was a case about a little boy who was, let me say, autistic.
Yes.
And them sprayed. And them sprayed with some marijuana spray and them started talk.
Yeah, man, all kind of that, and the oils and...
Yes.
Yeah.
So now, if we are on this island and we have the ratings of this marijuana thing now, it is a line towards an industry, right?
Yeah.
But here I say now, and this is where me kind of differ. Me not think our money really rests in the medicinal ganja. Me think the money from medicinal ganja will be channeled into the multinational major companies who have the infrastructure and the labs and the technicians.
No, medi marijuana.
Right, tell me about it.
Tell you about medi marijuana. Right. Medi marijuana where Canada will buy from Jamaica is marijuana with no insecticide, no pesticide, not moldy, and grown properly. That's where Canada, that's what it requires from us.
Okay.
In Jamaica to provide to Canadians who want medi marijuana to buy them, mm-hmm. says basically the same marijuana that is there. No, them no want
no artificial stuff.
No,
want
real, right. Yeah,
ital.
No ital herb,
yeah.
And it's nothing moly. And then we buy that as medi marijuana.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the understanding
that
me have
from the Canadians,
from some Canadian people.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what about those who are going to be the farmers of that now? There seem to be a struggle between...
Because there's a little controversy going on right now because for you to once... Because, you know, it's not fully out there,
right.
Legally.
Right.
But eventually, if you get a license to grow 1 acre or 2 acre, mm-hmm. and you have your license, then basically want you to buy the seed there from the seed bank. And there's a thing going on right now because it's like being controlled.
Right. Rastakura was speaking to the...
Yes, it's like being controlled. And that is what they're trying to force you to do, to buy, to grow that kind of marijuana. So me, that was a problem.
Mm-hmm.
But then if you're going into the byproducts of the marijuana,
yeah,
as in whatever, the soaps or whatever, and you want to use the original sensimilia or wherever it's planted, which is naturally grown in Jamaica,
yeah.
there will be, I think eventually then we try to facilitate that, because it's basically developing a product from our own natural resource.
You hear me now? You see the Canadian them?
Mm-hmm.
Them can go and hold it. You see me, you know, as a self-reliant African?
Mm-hmm.
Me, I say we for grow hemp.
Yeah, but then why we can't grow all of it?
No, well, say it again?
Why we can't grow hemp and marijuana?
Because.
Why it have to be a choice again?
Well, I'm going to tell you why the choice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you why. There are 2,500 products that can be made from hemp.
Hold on.
That don't require no high intensive
labor. Yeah, we know that.
Okay, and the employment.